tides rise and tides fall. Sometimes we sail by deep water and 6 hours later the same place can be dry. If you want to know more about why this happened, you can follow the link below to our episode, which explains it all. In this episode, we are going to learn how to work out how much water will be in a given place at a given time. First, you will need a tide table. This gives information about high and low water, the levels and the times. Don't forget to adjust the time if you need to for local time. Most tide tables are given in UTC. That's simple enough. But what happens if you want to balance somewhere in between high and low tides? One way of working this out is by using the rule of 12ths. First, calculate the range. It's not like that, Stefan. That's the difference between low and high water. In our example for June 17 in Falmouth, the range is 296 meters, so we'll call it 3. You need to divide this by 12, which gives you 25 centimeters. At low water, the depth will be about 1.5 meters plus chart datum, which is printed on the chart. An hour after low water, we need to add 1/12 of the range. In the second hour, you add another 2/12. And in the third and fourth hours after low tide, you add another 3/12 for each hour. In the fifth hour, you add 2/12 more. In the sixth hour, you add the last 12. If you are working from high water, do the same, but remember to subtract your 12s, not add them. To put it in another way, total depth minus water at high tide equals chart datum. Remember, it's okay to use 4.5 instead 4.48. That centimeter isn't going to make any difference. Whichever way you are doing it, the pattern is the same. For a 6 hour period, it's 1/12, 2/12, 3/12. Stefan, wait a moment. Then 3/12, 2/12, 1/12. You can use this method whenever you have a port with a regular tidal curve, like this one. You can also use the curve to calculate the height of tide instead of the rule of 12. Let's use the tidal information for Falmouth. To do this, mark low water and high water tidal heights on the scale. Then draw a line connecting these points. Then write a time of high water in the box and the times for 6 hours before and after. Draw a line from the time you want to know about up to the blue curve if it's a neap type or the red curve if it's springs. If you are not sure, you can work out the range from the tidal table. Then check in the box printed of the tidal curve. The next line comes horizontally from the red or blue curve to the line you draw at the chart connecting high and low water. Finally, one more line straight up to the scale gives you the height of the tide at your chosen time. If you want to know when the tide will be at a certain height, just do it all in reverse. First, connect your high and low water marks. Then, draw a line from the height of the tide you want until it joins the line. A further line horizontally will connect with the tidal curve. And one more going down to the time scale will give you your answer. Remember that the tidal curve gives you information about the height of tide. To find the depth of water, you add chart datum. In some places, you must always use a tidal curve and never the rule of 12s. This is because tides don't always behave as you would like them to.
You shall not pass!
One example is the Solent in southern England, where the tidal flow is disrupted by the Isle of Wight. In Portsmouth, where we have Amneris, we experience long high water stands. This means that the tide reaches its height before the official high water time, stays there for as long as 2 or 3 hours, then very quickly falls. It means that instead of typical 6 or so hours from high water to low, you can find that the tide can fall from its highest point to its lowest in just 3 hours. Just up the road in Southampton, things are even stranger. For there, they have double high tide. Just look at these predictions for 3 days in April. The movement of water there is so unusual that even a normal tidal curve is not good. Here is the Southampton tidal curve, very different from Falmouth. The only reliable prediction can be calculated from low water, not high. You might also want to know exactly how fast a tide is running and in which direction. But that's a story for another episode. Let's go sailing. Bye!